மழை தூறும் காலம் என் ஜன்னல் ஓரம் நிற்கிறேன். நீயும் நானும் ஒரு போர்வைக்குள்ளே சிறு மேகம் போலே மிதக்கிறேன். ஓடும் காலங்கள் உடனோடும் நினைவுகள் வழி மாறும் பயணங்கள் தொடர்கிறது. இதுதான் வாழ்க்கையா, ஒரு துணைதான் தேவையா, மனம் ஏனோ என்னையே கேட்கிறதே.
Hi everyone, I'm Andrea Jeremiah and I'm very happy to be on this episode of Loom Stories. When I did Pachakili Muthucharam, I didn't really want to be an actor. I was actually doing that film so I could earn some pocket money and go to study music at the Berklee College of Music in Boston. And I guess then life happened, you know, in the way it most often does, and took me on a completely different path. That's how I got to where I am now. A few years ago, I would have said music. Now, I have to say, my focus is actually more on acting. That's what's happened in the past few years. I think from the time I did Taramani and then Vada Chennai, and now I'm doing Pisasa 2. So the focus has most definitely shifted to acting. But having said that, we have worked on an album over the past year during the lockdown, my band and I, and it should be out this year. Music is always going to be my happy place, you know. It's always going to be the thing that makes me smile. But acting is my career path. Very, very clear about that now. With the advent of streaming, it's opened up so much of space for independent music artists all over the world, not just in India, because earlier you had to crack a record deal and that's a big process, you know. It's now anyone can upload their own music online and it's accessible to anyone in the whole wide world. So this opens up a window of opportunity for a lot of independent artists in every language. And now you have platforms, not just labels, but you know, newer platforms like Maja, and you have this massive hit called Enjoy Enjami, which clearly shows that a song does not have to be associated with a film to be accepted and loved by an audience. So I think it's great, and I think it's definitely going to bring about a positive change. Oh yeah, that was fun. I wasn't expecting to do that because I mean, it was a small role. I did it because I've never acted in a film with Vijay, and I have, of course, a lot of respect and admiration for him and the place that he's at, you know, in his career. And as a person, I think he's really one of the nicest people I've met in this industry. So yeah, when they told me I had to be dancing with him in this intro song, I freaked out because he's a really amazing dancer. And I think of myself as a, you know, just average, slightly above average kind of dancer, not a great dancer like him. So I freaked out. And then I had to do it in a sari, which was even crazier. But I think actually we managed quite well. When we were doing the rehearsal, he came up to me and he said, "Neenga nalla aadringa." I said, "Poi solaringa." Yeah. So, but it was fun. We did that in one take, actually. That whole dance bit is just a single take. So it was cute. Snow. Little snow came into my life at a not so great time. It was just after the lockdown. You know, everything was at its lowest. And he's really changed my life around so much in such an amazing, positive, healing, miraculous way. He's really the best thing that's happened to me in a very, very long time. In my house, I'm always in PJs and a t-shirt. Others, I'm always in jeans and a t-shirt. My sister keeps telling me, "You know, you're not a teenager. Stop wearing jeans and t-shirts all the time." But I generally just, that's my go-to thing. That would be, I think, in my 10th standard. You know, they have these these farewell kind of things in school. So all the girls had to wear saris. That's the first time I wore a sari. And I felt grown up. Over the years, I think I have grown to admire these beautiful things. They make you feel more of a woman. I actually can. I may not do a very good job with it, but I can drape a sari. I learned how to do that while I was shooting Varachanai, because you know, it didn't have to be perfect the way the sari was draped. It just had to look like a housewife would wear a sari. So I learned how to do it, but it wouldn't look like this for sure. Just always place yourself first, not in a selfish way, but you know, especially as a woman in this country, you're always taught to put yourself second, you know, because there's always, as a wife, your husband comes first. You know, I know families where the son gets more, I mean, they get better food, they get better education. When you're in a relationship, you know, you have to take care of your man or your boyfriend or whatever it is, you know, when you have a child, you know, obviously your child comes first. A woman is always putting herself second. And I think sometimes it's okay to put yourself first too, because it's the most important life skill you'll ever need, you know, is to constantly believe in yourself and count on yourself no matter what. Being an artist myself, you know, I'm always on the side of artists and artisans, whatever they may be. You know, they could be sculptors, they could be handloom artists. I think this is a work of art. A sari is a handloom sari is a work of art. And I think we should do whatever we can, whatever is in our power, to preserve every art form out there and preserve the precious hands that make these things and give them the due respect and make sure that they're supported. So I'm really glad that Sri Kumaran Stores has taken up this initiative, you know, to stress on the importance of handloom weavers. And maybe a few of them will watch these interviews and realize how much we value them.